Well, good morning to one and all, and welcome here to the Church of Immaculate Conception. My name is Father James Peterson. I'm the pastor here at IC, and to Star and to all of your kids and grandkids and great-grandkids, heartfelt prayers and condolences for you. We're gathered here with gratitude in our hearts for the life and the many years and memories you're able to share with Wayne, but also to pray for your own comfort and consolation, your strength and perseverance in these days. Just some practical items throughout our funeral liturgy for today. There'll be different moments for standing, sitting, kneeling, singing as you would like. I'll give you different promptings for those. But we're all gathered here with that hope of resurrection, of new life for Wayne, and one day for each and every one of us as well. At the beginning of our time, I invite you to please stand as we begin our time in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As our brother Wayne Hogan has died with the Lord, so may he live with him in glory. I'll sprinkle his urn here. Very nice green color with holy water. Reminder of his baptism being drawn to the family of Christ so many years ago. Now I invite you, as you're comfortable and able, to join in our opening hymn found in the blue hymnals, number 645, Amazing Grace, 645. Let us pray. God of endless ages, from one generation to the next, you have been our refuge and strength. Before the mountains were born or the earth came to be, you are God. Have mercy now on your servant, Wayne James Hogan, whose long life was spent in your service. Give him a place in your kingdom where hope is firm for all who love and rest is sure for all who serve. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated for our liturgy of the word. Those who will be helping with the readings can come forward at this time.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. a time of war and a time of peace. The word of the Lord. Reading from the book of Revelation. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. As you're able, I invite you to please stand for the Holy Gospel.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated. Again, to you, the family gathered here today, our heartfelt prayers and condolences are with you. Grateful to God for the 85 years of life that the Lord gave to Wayne here this side of heaven. But at the same time, there's always the sense of sadness, the sense of absence, the sense of loss for someone who's been there for so many years. And so with good reason, if you have that sense of sadness and heartache, if you have tears that come to your eyes, that's all right. It's completely understandable. Those are visible signs of that love and care, the appreciation you have for Wayne. Something that lines up very well in that second reading that we heard today, very well proclaimed there from the book of Revelation. We heard about the day after our time here on earth when all of our pain, all of our suffering, all of our heartache will be wiped away. In the kingdom of heaven, there is no more pain, no more death. There's only life, peace, and joy. So that's something that we ourselves press onward in this life and look forward to. Something that we heard within that first reading, also very well proclaimed today from the Old Testament, the book of Ecclesiastes. Now, for some folks in our congregation, perhaps your generation will remember the song by the Byrds in the 1960s, of "To Everything There Is a Season, Turns, Turns." You remember that song? That's based on this particular passage from Ecclesiastes 3, verses 1 to 10. And so I was really calling to mind that experience of life where we have the good, the bad, the ugly, everything in between. That's our experience here on earth. As a brief kind of aside, within the Old Testament from the original Hebrew, that was written as an acrostic poem. So kind of the equivalent would be if you would write in English and start with a letter A and go through all the letters of the alphabet to describe a particular person or experience. So maybe as we think about Wayne, we could describe him in an acrostic poem as amazing, bold, caring, daring, etc., etc. So different ways that we can think about our experience here on earth. We know that God's amazing grace is with us. We sang about that at the very beginning with our Scola group, with Dr. Ray leading the way there. We ourselves know that indeed God's grace helps us, sustains us and strengthens us when we ourselves don't have any of that. God watches over us with the shadow of his proverbial wings, as we sang there in our responsorial song of eagle's wings. You know that God indeed is with us. Now, full disclosure, I didn't have a chance to get to know Wayne very well here on earth, but the family did. And so after communion today, we'll hear from the family, their own words, eulogy, stories, and memories. And then you yourselves afterwards, downstairs in our fellowship hall, you're invited to do the same, to share those wonderful moments and memories. But something that I do know about Wayne, and looking at his very names, is that he was a person who was very loved and cared for, and you can be the judge if he lived out what his names at the etymological or the root level mean. So his name of Wayne means a wagon driver. I don't know if he ever drove any wagons, or if any drove any of you crazy, but, you know, we can look at that. He's someone who was driving through the streets of life with God's amazing grace to help him and to sustain him, certainly with Star for so many years, and all of you who have come into this world through that loving dynamic. His middle name, perhaps I'm partial, it's my same name as well. It's an unusual name from the Hebrew that originally means one who takes the place of another. So originally it was meant for Jacob, who was the brother of Esau. He kind of took his place in terms of the order of things of the Old Testament. And so we look at Wayne's life, and maybe he took the place of, you know, former boyfriends or other people who are there, but he's one who took that special place within all of your hearts. The last name, the family name of Hogan, not only Hogan's Heroes, in honor of that great show from back in the day, the name itself means one who is a youthful warrior. So I don't know if at times in his life Wayne was more cantankerous or more of a warrior, but sometimes we need that in life. We got to be a little bit of stubborn to get through these challenging days, especially in this Minnesota winter, the ups and downs and the ice and snow and everything in between. So we ourselves, we look at that, the very namesake of Wayne. We give thanks to God for the years of life he was able to experience and you were able to share with him here on earth. And we look forward, pressing on to the day that we're reunited with him and all of our loved ones who go on to eternal life. We'll be able to praise God there in his mercy forever and ever. Amen. God bless you all. Well, I invite you to please stand once again as we lift up our prayers and petitions to God, our merciful Father. Our response to these prayers will be, hear our prayer. For Wayne, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer, that we may find the joy of knowing the truth to be found with our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer,
that those unable to be with us today may feel supported in their sorrow. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer,
for our deceased relatives and friends and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer,
for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer,
and for all those prayers you bring before Jesus this day from the depths of your heart. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this day with gratitude for the goodness of your Son, Jesus, he who suffered and died upon the cross, but then was raised up on the third day to raise us to new life. He indeed is the way, the truth, and the life. Wayne believed this and lived this here on earth. May we one day join him in your heavenly kingdom to praise you there in your glory forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated. And after each of these respective prayers, if you want to respond with, blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God
forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink. I invite you to please stand and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all of
us, Holy Church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Wayne, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful Judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. I invite you to please kneel at this time, otherwise you may be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, Joseph, his assistant, and all the clergy, remember your servant, Wayne Hogan, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. You to please stand once again. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace to you all. Peace.
Thank you.
Pastor Abel, invite you to please kneel, otherwise you may be seated. We are very soon coming to the moment of Holy Communion, along with St. Isichek, our sacristan and Eucharistic minister. We'll be in front here for the two different sides of the church. We as Catholic Christians believe this is indeed the body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus. If you'll be coming forward to receive our Eucharistic Lord, ask that you extend your hands as such. Otherwise, if you're out of another faith tradition or not prepared to receive Jesus in Holy Communion today, you can still come forward to receive a blessing by crossing your arms in front of you. But all of us are gathered here with gratitude within our hearts for the life of dear Wayne, praying for him and for God's blessings upon each and every one of you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Well, as I mentioned during the homily, I wanted to give the family an opportunity to offer words of remembrance for dear dad and grandpa and great-grandpa. So for those who'll be helping with our words of remembrance and eulogy, I invite you to go forward to the amble at this time.
Thank you, Father. I love the explanation of his name, because he was a wagon driver. He was he drove truck for 30 years and put on a lot of millions of miles. Thank you, everybody who came to honor Wayne today. I'm Lynn Jorstad. Wayne always called me just Jorstad. Stanley, he called the Pollock. We were his coffee buddies. And you people know what he called you. He had nicknames for all of you. You know that. Star asked if I would get up and talk about Wayne. 7 minutes? Well, that's kind of close. But she called me later and said that Terry and her, she had messed up on the obituary. She said Wayne was a truck driver for 60 years. She hoped no one would notice. I don't think they did, Star. He had 30 years as a Teamster career and 28 years in retirement. The more I thought about that statement, she and Terry were right. I am a convert to Catholicism, and my wife Eileen always tells me, once a Catholic, always a Catholic. I say, once a truck driver, always a truck driver. And when Wayne and I and our buddies would get together, the stories would always come out, and they'd always be about our driving experience or his baseball playing at Columbia Heights. And one of the guys just reminded me back there that he was the best catcher that ever came out of the school, Immaculate Conception. Those memories of driving trucks. We went through blizzards. We went through ice. I woke up one time in Illinois and the truck was stopped. And I looked out and Wayne said, you can't even stand up. I don't know. I got the truck off the road. He was amazing. He had an amazing career. He was an amazing driver. There's another driver here in the back, Olin, that drove with him when Olin was 54 and Wayne was 51, running sleeper teams to the West Coast, to Idaho. And they pulled 3 trailers. I thought Bob and Pat had run together as first, but it was, Bob and Wayne, but it was Pat and Wayne, I found out this morning, that drove truck over the road. And I said, how'd you get along? And Pat told me, the people at the station would say, well, the Hogan brothers are out arguing in their truck again. So they got along just fine. He was also, Wayne loved driving because he started his career in Kansas as a 15-year-old driving grain truck. I don't know if a lot of you knew that, but he made sure we all knew that. Then he was on team with Al, his buddy Al, and they were on team for almost 13 years together. More than one-third of his career was spent in the back of a truck, sleeping or driving that truck, in a cab-over truck mostly. And the cab-overs, it's called a cab-over because the cab is over the engine. It's not like your car where the engine is out in front of you. And it always had a beautiful hum to it, and I spent a lot of time in those sleepers with Wayne, too. As a sleeper team driver, you would not really sleep until the second day or the third day. You slept in a cocoon of a sleeper. When I first started, it was 22 inches wide and 78 inches long. I had to sleep diagonally in it to do it. Wayne didn't have that problem. So when you couldn't sleep, you'd get up and you'd share life stories. And that's how everybody got to know Wayne. Everybody that drove truck with Wayne knew his whole life story. And we became closer. Anybody that drove at All-American from 1979 till 1988 will tell you that's the best company, the best family they ever came from, except their real families, you guys. And that was the truth. Brandi Carlile's song, The Story. The lines across my face tell the stories of my life. So many stories to tell, but they don't mean anything unless you have someone to tell them to. That's you. And he did, to all of us. Catholic school, he always told me, I would admonish him. You missed Sunday Mass. He said, let me tell you, Buster, he said, I spent more time on my knees before the eighth grade than you're going to spend the rest of your life. So, I don't know if he told any of you that, but he did. There was also, Wayne loved baseball, and the priest was hauling the whole team in his 46 Chevy big old car, hauled the whole team across town to a game, and he was distracted, probably by Wayne. He sideswiped the car, and some vulgarities came out, and then they were all sworn to an oath that nobody would ever find that out, but Wayne could never keep a secret. Wayne loved his family. Joe and Irene raised him right. Wayne would bring Gary Tutsky over to their house and say, hey, can Gary eat with us? His mom would say, sure, I'll put some more water in the soup. And come in. That's the kind of people they were, the Hogans, welcoming all the time. And Wayne loved baseball. He started out with 2 strikes and 6 kids. Then he hit a home run. He married Star with 2 R's. He told me that. And Danny, who came into his life. Wayne always had a vision. Maybe looking down the highway and where the road would take him. His life and his driving career had similarities. It had some bumps, it had some detours, had some flat tires and some blown engines. But the road was always there, welcoming him back. On his journey. When we were young, we looked up and saw our older generation leaving us. We loved that generation. When Wayne and I met, we were in the middle of our generation. I was 29 when I met Wayne. He was 42 and still driving a sleeper truck. Back then, there were no cell phones, no social media. Our social media was on the AM radio, news, and newspapers. Media was great. That's the only way we knew it. But we did have CB radios. And Wayne could talk and talk and talk. You all know that. I hear him. His handle was Doorknob. I don't know. I still don't remember where he got that. Until I met members of his family, I did not know that their own handle had been given to him, Wiener. And I don't know if that was some pre-puberty thing or something. I'm not sure. Wayne and Star moved to the big house and the pool. All of you that are here, we're at the big house in the pool. My kids, all of them over there, grew up at Wayne's house in the pool. They loved it. He treated everybody with so much respect. And then the parties. The first party was his wedding reception. I had just gotten a video camera. I taped that video, the reception. Wayne said you always needed Dramamine before you could watch it, because I wasn't very good. Missy rescued me, though. She taped a rock concert over it, and the verbal abuse that I took from Wayne ended. Then retirement started. A place up lake at the north, and then living in Arizona. He was on the retirement highway. He got another new family down in Arizona. Some of them are here today. From the song by Cat Stevens, Father and son, I am old, but I am happy. And that was Wayne. He really wasn't old. He was 85, but he wasn't old. He was still a kid. He really was. As we say goodbye today to Wayne, he is never gone until the last person in this room and on this earth says his name. If any of you know the song Memories by Maroon 5, I'd like to read a couple of lines that I think. Here's to the ones we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Because the drink brings us back to our memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones we lost on the way. Because the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back you. Wayne was electric. He had an electric personality. He gave static and got static back, and we all love him for it. God bless Wayne.
Thank you very much, Jorstad, for your words and for your witness, for your friendship with Wayne. That was really very, very touching, and I like how you interwove all the different songs from pop culture. As I was hearing the story of Wayne and being a truck driver, it reminded me of Roll On from Alabama. 18-wheeler, great song, yeah. One of the classics. Well, thank you again for that. For one final time today, I invite all of you to please stand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Wayne may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
What's customary within our Catholic Christian funeral liturgy is to have either more holy water at the end of the Mass or incense, and we're actually going to use a little bit of incense, so if you have an aversion to it, it'll just be for a few moments, but it's within the Psalms of the Old Testament. It says that just as the smoke from the incense rises up, so too do our prayers rise up to God in heaven. As I do that, incensing Wayne's urn over here, Dr. Ray and our Scola choir group will lead us in a farewell song, which you can sing along to, or you can just take this as a time of quiet, reflective prayer. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Wayne James Hogan, in assurance, certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, you will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Wayne in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And a word of gratitude to all of you for your presence here. As I mentioned, our fellowship hall, you can go down the stairwell just to your right as you leave the church, or there's an elevator there too, if that's easier for you. And there'll be a time for food and fellowship. You know, maybe like the Maroon 5 song, there'll be some drinks down there, but it won't be maybe the drinks you're used to. We've got coffee, water, lemonade. But it'll still be a time to share memories of dear Wayne and your time together. Thank you to Vicki Bazile, our pastoral coordinator, who helped connect with the family to plan out today's liturgy, beautiful selections of readings and music. Thank you to Dr. Ray, our director of music and liturgy, and our cantor for the day, along with our Scola group. Thank you to Rick, our usher, to Chris, our server, to Sandy, our Eucharistic minister and sacristan, and to our friends at Kozlak Radulovich for helping with the funeral. Well, in peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest. Thanks be to God.